Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Shawntae's Way here today. And today I wanted to talk to you guys about more of intuitive living. You guys heard me say on my channel, if you've been following me for a while, probably like 2 years ago, I know that I told you guys that I started to do like an intuitive living lifestyle. I started with only doing my food lifestyle that way. And then I actually just figured out that that's a actual lifestyle and a way of living, which I have been doing way prior to even switching to intuitive lifestyle living. So it's pretty easy to get into the flow of that lifestyle because it's super easy. And I'm gonna explain to you guys it today. You guys voted on my community tab for me to do a spirituality based video. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that for you guys today. And hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or anything like that, you can leave them down in the comment section, or anything you want to add to this video, you guys can leave it in the comment section because I love to read your comments and see what you guys think about the video and things like that. So let's go ahead and get right into it. So for those of you who do not know anything about intuitive living and you're just kind of like, what, like, why are you even talking about this? I'm gonna tell you that listening to your intuition and living on an intuitive based lifestyle is probably the best and most natural thing you can ever do. It's your innate ability that you were actually born with. Everyone has an intuition. It's your basically a gut feeling that you get from your inner knowing. Your inner self tells you through your five senses, so your taste, your smell, your eyes, like all your senses, you're actually able to know and have knowledge about things before it even happens. Like I said, everyone is born with an intuition. There are some people who have stronger intuitions, and because they're more in tune with themselves, or they have practice, or I honestly think being close to God actually makes your intuition a lot stronger. Whereas there are other people who don't really, it's like a muscle. So there's other people who don't really work their intuition, but if they still have it, but it's just not as strong. So for example, you may always contact a close friend or a mom or something when you need advice because they always know what to do. Or your friend or mom may call you at times when you're not even like talking to them, but they call you and they're like, okay, what's going on? Like, what's wrong with you? Like, I feel like that there's something wrong with you. Like, is everything okay? And you'll be like just sitting there and you'll be sad or something. You'll be like, how does she know that something was wrong with me? How did she pick that up? What is going on? Normally those are the people who have very strong intuitions, or they're extremely connected to where they can feel other people's feelings. That being said, we are supposed to be going through life using our intuition and using our inner knowing. Of course, we have everyone around us to kind of like help at times, but most of the time, all that you need to know about yourself is within. So that's the definition and kind of like the wide definition of what an intuition is. It's an innate knowing. It's a inner knowing of what to do before you even have physical evidence. So today I'm going to pretty much talk to you guys about how to actually live an intuitive lifestyle. I was taught more about this when I was studying for my holistic health coaching certificate, and that was back in 2018. So I was listening to a lot of seminars when I had to go through the training, and I listened to a lot of different ways of living and a lot of different diets and a lot of different this and a lot of different that, just a wide range of different things that people recommend. And I remember listening to this speaker, which I always tell you guys about her. I can't remember her name. And then if I try to share the video with you guys, it won't allow me because they only want IIN students to be aware and have that type of information. So a lot of the amazing content and videos that I would like to share with you guys, they don't allow you to share them. So I'm just gonna have to tell you guys based on my perception and what I learned from the video. So I listened to a seminar where a lady was talking about how she ran an entire company based on holistic health, you know, telling people to eat vegan, telling people to do yoga. It was pretty much like a holistic coaching practice. And she had very rich clients that had very abundant lifestyles and that were super healthy and that were drinking green juice on the daily. But when they would come to her for her counseling, she said they would have migraine issues, thyroid issues, they would have be having depression, and she could not figure out for the life of her if these people had such great diets, such great lifestyles, they were rich, they had yoga sessions every single day, they were doing all these things that she was telling them to do, and they were still coming back to her with, you know, illnesses and diseases and, you know, just not feeling at the best when within. They were still feeling depressed and sad. So her and a couple other health coaches got together and they pretty much studied their clients and did this little study. And they came up with the fact that people are not as happy when they are following kind of like a, I wouldn't say like a routine, but a system. So these people were like following a system. So they were doing all these things, but they weren't really listening or doing what their actual body wanted them to do. They weren't listening to their actual self. They were more so just like following a strict system instead of listening to who they wanted to be and what their body wanted to be. And at the end of the day, even though they were doing all these good things that was benefiting them, if you're not happy, it even has scientific proven that if you're not happy, your food doesn't even absorb in your body the right way. You're not even absorbing your nutrients the right way. If you're not comfortable within yourself, other things are not going to be comfortable in your body as well. So it's not going to get to your cells and give you the nutrients anyways. And this is what she explained. Basically, she mentioned to her clients, she threw out her whole system that she was giving them, and she mentioned to her clients to just live kind of like an intuitive lifestyle. She would tell them to love themselves, start giving themselves good prep talk, start talking nice to theirself, don't follow any strict diets, just start doing exactly what you want to do. And she instructed her clients to do that. And some of them were like coming back, oh my God, like I feel so much better. Like I'm not as sick anymore, or I don't have migraines all the time anymore because like I'm being easy on myself and I'm just following what I want for myself. And it's just helping a lot. So after that, she ended up switching all of her practice over to intuitive living. I'm gonna have to find her name. Intuitive living, intuitive eating, only eat what you intuitively want for that day or need for that day. She switched her entire practice over to intuition-based living. And she basically said in her seminar that if you live your life based on how you want to feel, if you live your life based on how you are feeling. So what I mean by that is there will be some weeks and days where I will just want to eat vegetables and fruits all the time. And for that whole week, like I'll just have like a super plant-based diet where I'm just eating very healthy because I feel that's what my body needs. I'm not feeling as energized, or I'm not feeling as I would normally feel. So I would kind of like switch it up for a couple of weeks, and then boom, 3 weeks later, my body wants, you know, okay, go have like a snack, or go have some fish, or go have this, or go have that, and then I'll switch it up again. So one thing we need to remember, and I feel like this is for everyone, but of course you want to follow what you have set out for yourself. But one thing that we need to remember is that the body is continuously changing. Mother Earth doesn't even stay the same. There's always seasons. There's always new things going on. Always new things going on in this world. Just look at like nature around you and see how it reacts and see that it's constantly changing, and you would know that you're actually built that way as well. So you can learn a lot from just looking at nature, seeing how nature is doing. Because at the end of the day, we're not anything much different. We have different needs, but the base needs that the nature needs, we also need as well. Everyone goes through phases and everyone needs a change every now and then. So if you are just doing something because that's your routine and that's how you've done it for years and you don't want people to look at you like, why did you all of a sudden change? You're not really living off of your intuition. That is not intuitive living. Intuitive living is doing things the way that you want to do them, the way that your body's calling you to do them. For example, I was vegan for 6 years, 2 years prior to me quitting vegan. I was like, I don't know if I can like quit vegan because like I just don't think that that's right, because I've always said that vegan was right, so I can't just like switch up all of a sudden, so I'm just gonna continue to do this. So I was doing my vegan lifestyle for 2 years more than what my body actually wanted me to do it, and I was definitely experiencing a lot of things during that time to where I was basically just having an unbalanced diet. Even though it was considered healthy, it was still unbalanced. And I remember talking to a herbalist who talked to me about, she actually is a herbalist that does like Japanese and Korean medicine. Feng Shui, I don't know if that's Japanese or Korean, but she actually told me when I went to talk to her, and I used to get my teas from her, she actually told me that she thought that I should change my diet. I went through 4 herbalists who told me that I need to change my diet before I actually changed my diet. And they all gave me different perspectives. The first one is the one that stuck with me the most, the Feng Shui herbalist, because she told me basically what I'm telling you guys now, that living a balanced lifestyle is what is most natural to the body. So she basically told me, you going from one extreme to the next. So, okay, I had an unhealthy lifestyle and then I went to vegan, which is way healthier. But after a while, your body also wants a change. So she said that now you're living on the extreme side because your body is now out of balance and you're not really paying attention. And instead of you going kind of like back to the middle, kind of being in the back on the balance scale, you're still sitting over here and the scale is kind of like uneven now because you're not listening to yourself. So I had to actually change my diet, and I will go into more in depth on that on another video, but I had to actually change my diet to where I started to slowly add in like fish and things like that, and I actually like this diet a lot better. It's a lot better for my body. Of course, I don't full blown like eat meat all the time because that honestly isn't good for myself. But she explained to me that balance is the best thing and the best way to live life. And that's all your intuition is going to basically lead you to. It's never going to lead you to one extreme. It's always going to give you balance. Now, I do feel that balance is different for everyone because we all have different lifestyles. So someone who has been eating junk and eating extremely bad for them like all their life, if they go vegan, that's not an extreme for them because they haven't been getting their nutrients anyway. So actually going vegan will probably balance them out a lot. I never criticize or say a diet is bad. So if you are vegan and you have been vegan for years and years and years and that has worked for you, then that's okay as well. This lifestyle doesn't really judge. It's just more of what is it that is good for you and what makes you feel good and what makes you happy and what makes you feel more alive. That's what you need to do. So if you're wondering how can you get more in tune and kind of start being more in tune with your body so you can even hear your intuition, because your intuition is not super loud or pushy, it's very subtle. So in order for you to hear, you kind of have to slow down, reflect, and you have to be kind of patient with yourself so that you can actually connect with yourself. I also say if you are a person who literally just, you don't know what I'm talking about, you're like, I don't get those type of senses and feelings, I highly recommend that you start to journal, that you start to read more like self-help books, and you know, pay attention to the lessons that you get in life, because wisdom is very big part of knowing and inner knowing. And all through life we have lessons, and if you actually pay attention to the lessons and grasp the lessons, they don't continue to cycle over and over in your life, and you can actually gain wisdom from those lessons, and those lessons can actually be a navigational system for you as well, so that in life you have discernment, and the discernment is going to fall in with your intuition as well. Another thing I want to point out to you guys is I mentioned in the beginning that that intuitive living is not judgmental, and your intuition is not judgmental as well. So when you are doing a intuitive lifestyle, make sure that you are going with the flow. Yes, we need to do action 100%. We do have to go out and do things, but there are times where you don't have to do as much. You can kind of just like allow things to come to you. For instance, if you say, oh, I want to learn more about, you know, intuitive living, and then this video pops up in your recommendations, that is life flowing to you. So remember that when you speak things, when you think things, when you feel things, you're actually attracting them to you. And you always want to make sure that when you are doing like an intuitive based living, that you always let go and flow with the with life and allow things to come to you, which can be a lot harder than what it sounds. If you can consciously do it, I do recommend that you do that. Once you start getting intuitive nudges of what to do and hunches and gut feelings about people, places, things, make sure that you listen to them, because if you don't listen to your intuition becomes more and more quiet. It just starts to quiet down even more. So make sure that you pay attention to your surroundings and your feelings and how you feel around certain people, places, or things. For example, if you get an intuitive nudge to go to a yoga class, and you're like, oh, I've never been into yoga. This whole time I've been on this planet, I've never liked yoga, so why would I go? And then, you know, your best friend comes to you and say, hey, you want to go to yoga with me? I just started. And you're like, what? And you still like, oh no. And your intuition's like telling you like, go, this is something new, go. And then you finally go to yoga and you start to meet new people, or you meet your soulmate there, or something crazy happens that you're just like, what? If I would have never listened to myself, I wouldn't have met this person, or I wouldn't have been able to make this lifestyle change, or I would have never met these new people who have completely different perspectives from me, which are now teaching me to have a different perspective. So everything in life, I feel, is always sort of teaching you something. People, places, things, activities, they're all there to teach you something, and nothing is done in vain. Everything has a meaning behind it. Something always has a beneficial enhancement to it. It's always going to enhance you. So, or it can be the opposite, where it doesn't enhance you. It gives you like, you know, a bad outcome, but then again, you still learn a lesson. So it kind of does enhance you, because if you actually learn the lesson, then you can use that wisdom to help someone else so that they don't fall into the same tracks that you did. Just depends on how you incorporate that into your life. But I wanted to share this with you guys. You should definitely look it up. Intuitive living is amazing. It's the way to live. It's our innate ability to live. It's who we are. It's who we were born to be. We were born to listen to our inner self, and those around us are here to help as well. So guys, if you are wanting to do this lifestyle, you have to take some time to yourself. You cannot be around 50,000 people trying to get your life together. It just doesn't work. That doesn't work. That's people who are really, really getting their life together. They are normally doing that alone. It takes a little bit of alone time, because you have to get along with yourself to see what do you have to pick apart, what do you have to get down to the nitty-gritty of. If you want a lot of people around you and you want to be distracted, then you can do the surface work and get the surface results. But if you actually want to get a better lifestyle and you actually want to be more in tune with yourself, you will have to get time alone by yourself. You're honestly probably going to have to let some people go, and you're going to have to really dig in so that you can actually enjoy your life a lot better. Having 50,000 friends and 20,000 people around you is not good. And I know we see that a lot on Instagram and stuff, where people are like, oh yeah, party, 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 my life is perfect and I have so many friends. Guys, don't believe it. Always connect with yourself, by yourself, because that you have to, because that is who knows you the best. So I wanted to stick that in here. That was my little spill on intuitive living. I want to bring awareness to that topic and let you guys know a lot more about it, because it's super important. So I want to know what you guys would like to know more about on that topic, and I will elaborate more on it. This is just like the base, how to live intuitive and what living intuitive even is. If you guys want to know more about the eating, if you guys want to know more about just more in-depth stuff, then let me know down in the comment section and I'll make a different video about it. It's in all areas of your life, so it can be a whole spill of things. Yeah. Let me know some more in-depth topics that you would like for me to talk about, and let me know if you enjoy this video and if it was helpful to you, and if you're going to look more into living a intuitive lifestyle after this video. I would like to know. Let me know down in the comment section. Don't forget to thumbs up this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.